This is the place to praise him, man. This is the place to thank him, man. This is the time to thank him, man. This is a good time to thank him, man. Thank God for the house of the Lord, man. Amen. Thank you, Jesus, amen. Joshua chapter 6 and verse number 6. Pray for the word. And Joshua, the son of Nun, called the priest and said to them, take up the Ark of the Covenant, and let seven priests bear seven trumpets of ram's horns before the Ark of the Lord. Let's bow for a word of prayer. Thank you, Holy Spirit, for being in us and with us and guiding us and leading us in worship. Thank you for your presence, Lord. Thank you for exalting Jesus. Thank you for touching your sheep, Lord, and ministering to all of us, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We come asking that we continue to exalt you, Lord. Continue to praise you. We know it's all about you, Lord. Feed your lambs and feed your sheep alike with thus saith the Lord. Then, Lord, thank you for hearing our prayers this morning. We have many, many prayers this morning, many needs this morning, but we thank you for your word that says, my God shall supply all my needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. Thanks for blessing every home and every household, Lord. We always pray your will be done here on earth as it is in heaven. And may the laws be saved. May every soul be blessed. May your holy will be done. And we'll be careful to give you all the praises, glory, and honor. In Jesus' name we pray. Loose the blessings of God and thy living. In Jesus' name, amen. Give God a hand of praise, amen. We give honor to God who sent his Son, Jesus Christ, who hung, bled, died on the cross of Calvary. And thank God that on the third day, he got up from the grave. That's the gospel, and that's the good news. We want to use as a subject this morning, as a subject title this morning, God is never in a hurry, amen. Hallelujah, amen. You share with some kind neighbor that God is never in a hurry, amen. Always right on time, amen. After Joshua received his orders from the captain of the Lord's army, then he gave the same order to the priests and to the people. After he heard from the Lord, then he told the people what the Lord would have for them to do. Amen. When the children of Israel crossed the Jordan River, the Ark of the Covenant, or the Ark of the Lord, is mentioned 16 times in Joshua chapter 3 and chapter 4. Y'all gonna pray with me? The Ark symbolized the presence of God. In order to ensure victory, Israel must have the presence of God. Am I right about it? As a matter of fact, Moses was insistent upon the presence of God being with him before they made the journey. Amen. He had to have the presence of God. Can I back it up this morning? If you go with me to Exodus chapter 33 and look at verses 15 and 16, the Bible says, "And he said unto him, If thy presence go not with me, carry us not up hence." All right, does your Bible say that? "For wherein shall it be known here that I and thy people have found grace in thy sight? Is it not in that thou goest with us?" Thank you, Jesus. "So shall we be separated, I and thy people, from all the people that are upon the face of the earth." If the Lord wasn't with them, then there would be no victory. Tell your neighbor, if the Lord is not with you, there's not going to be any victory. I know that for sure, amen. You've got to have God with you, amen. Can I back it up? If you go with me to Joshua chapter 6 and look at verses 7 and 8, the Bible says, "And he said unto the people, Pass on and compass the city, circle the city, and let him that is armed pass on before the ark of the Lord." Does your Bible say that? And it came to pass, when Joshua had spoken unto the people, that the seven priests bearing the seven trumpets of ram's horns passed on before the Lord. Can you say before the Lord? And blew with the trumpets, and the ark of the covenant of the Lord followed them. Does your Bible say that? Does your Bible say that? First, they had to have a rite of circumcision before they invaded Jericho. Get ready to go to war, and then you're going to have a circumcision ritual. Well, that didn't make sense right there. And then he get ready to go, and he said, now it's time to celebrate the Passover before invading Jericho. And now, before invading, God tells them, instead of going in and just getting them, you've got to march around the walls. Don't invade yet until you march around the walls. You're ready to fight, and you're ready to get it on, and you wonder, what's the holdup? Tell three neighbors that God is not in a hurry. Before the fight gets on. You got me, Holy Ghost. And if I may use my sanctified imagination, I imagine some of the officers started to grumble. Oh, why don't we just go in and take these guys, invade these guys? What's all this marching around about? We're just wasting time. Inheritance. I'm ready to get that which belongs to me. I imagine another officer might have said, it won't take all that. Just to conquer this one city, we got to do all of that. If I can still use my imagination, I imagine another officer said, does it take a whole week to conquer these guys? And these walls look awfully thick. We need to get on and get at it. Would you tell three neighbors, God is not in a hurry. I'll get there in a minute. But what are we doing? here to tell you that God had him to march around that wall again and again until they came to the conclusion that it was impossible to do this without him. The first time they walked around those walls, they must have looked awfully tall, awfully thick, awfully huge, and awfully awesome. Before they got into the land, God wanted to teach them that life's victory does not depend on their might, help me, Holy Ghost, and on their power, or on their sword, or on their shield. Victory is totally dependent on the Lord. You tell me, he was neighbor.
Tear it down.
verse 14. The Bible says, help me, Holy Ghost, is anything too hard for the Lord? Watch it now. At the time appointed, somebody said appointed. Somebody said appointed time. He says, I will return unto thee according to the time of life, and Sarah shall have a son. Somebody said appointed time. God could have torn down the wall on the first day, but God has an appointed time. The first day wasn't the appointed time. See, God is not just in the business of tearing down walls. He doesn't have a wall tearing down company, amen. A wrecking company. He wasn't in the wall wrecking business. He was in the business of working on Israel's character. Talk to me, somebody. He was molding them. He was shaping them for the future. He had to teach them some principles for how to receive the promises of God. You have to be able to receive the promises of God. Can I show you how to receive the promises of God? Come on with me to Hebrews chapter 6 and look at verse number 12. Hebrews 6 and 12. The Bible says, Hebrews 6 and 12. The Bible says, that ye be not slothful. Somebody said slothful. But followers of them, watch it now, who through what? Faith and what? Through faith and patience inherit the promises. God is never in a hurry. God has an appointed time for you to receive your blessings. Come on me now. If you get it at the wrong time, you won't appreciate it. Talk to me, somebody. You may abuse it. You may break it. You may leave it. You may tear it up. You may think it's one thing and it's something else. Come on, talk to me, somebody. You may get arrogant. You may get full of pride. You may walk around with your chest stuck out. If you give it to you too early, how many of you are glad that some things you asked for God didn't give it to you? Amen. Talk to me, somebody. Somebody say appointed time. He wants us to learn faith and patience that we might be mature in our Christian walk. Come on, Holy Ghost. Mature in our faith. Talk to me, somebody. Mature in our patience. He wants us to be spiritually grown up so we can handle the blessings of God. If you're not mature, you will mess up a blessing. How many of folks can mess up a blessing? How many folks can mess up a good thing? If you don't know what it's made for, you can mess it up, amen. He couldn't let them just go in there and knock those folks out the first day. If they would have knocked him out the first day, they would have been strutting around like peacocks. Look at me. Look at what I did. Been singing a song, I did it my way. Instead of Yahweh, amen. Talk to me, somebody. Talk to me, somebody. I did it my way instead of Yahweh, amen. Talk to me, somebody. Impatience, somebody said impatience, was one of Israel's biggest problems. One of their biggest sins. They had a problem with impatience. Can I back it up? Abraham had Ishmael because of impatience. Talk to me, somebody. King Saul had a whole lot of problems because he couldn't wait on the priest, amen. King Uzziah got leprosy because he couldn't wait on the priest. Peter cut off the servant's ear because he couldn't wait on the Lord. Ask your neighbor, what did you do because of impatience. Amen. Say, Pastor, what did you do? Amen. I got mine, you got yours. Amen. Tell your neighbors, God is not in a hurry. Come on, God is not in a hurry. Come on, God is not in a hurry. Through faith and patience, you inherit the promises of God. Can I back it up? Joshua chapter 6 and verse number 9. The Bible says, and the armed men went before the priests that blew with the trumpets, and the reward came after dark. The priests going on and blowing with the trumpets. So I said they blew the trumpets.